What's good, guys? It's your boy. Today's video, we're going to be talking about the deck that started it all for me. The deck that made me fall in love with this game of Yu-Gi-Oh! That's right. Pendulum Magicians.
Hoping you take that jump.
No way. Don't
feel just a game. It's just a game. Okay. Alright, go get some Starbucks. You guys are going to love this video. So hit the subscribe button. Smash the like button. Let's get straight into the video. Let's go, baby! Pendulum Magicians are back! I've been an outspoken critic of this deck. But ever since the release of the new Magician, Empyrean Magician, whatever it's called, the Perform Bell Magician, this deck is busted, man. It is so much better than before because you get a free plus one every single turn. And it truly makes Pendulum Magicians as broken as they were with Sky Iris. Be on the lookout, guys. Be on the lookout for this deck. Let's go. Let's go, baby. Let's go. Friendly reminder, guys, before we get started, do check out our beautiful I Am In Demon Cloth playmats in the description below. Now, let's go. As you see here, we do have a dead shrine with the Pen Called Darkworm, and that's all good. You do have Pen Called Darkworm, so I'm not going to complain. But I would rather shrine first. So I understand you have Pen Called Darkworm, but always shrine first, because if your opponent's going to add this, shrine is definitely ashable, even though they see Servant. It's definitely ashable. I'd rather them ash at them pen call. If they don't ash, it doesn't matter. You still win because pen best deck. As I said it before, who can say it best for me? 10 negates or any hand trap. That's exactly what we're about to do here. We're doing 6 negates with 4 cards in hand. And it's just a new combo. Whether you have 4 cards in hand or 3 cards in hand, you always have 3 plus cards in your hand at the end of the turn because of cards like Bambuku, Darkroom's going to plus, pen call's going to get you the plus from the new magician card. That's why it's so broken. Now pen call equals a plus 2 because Oaf is gonna get you a plus 1, like a plus 3. Harmo is gonna get you a plus 1. The new magician is gonna get you a plus 1. There's just so many new plus 1s, and the deck is just super nice. Here we're gonna be doing a play. It's a little unorthodox, the combo we're gonna be showing, guys. I believe this should be the new magician combo moving forward, utilizing all their cards. You do want to ensure, as you notice, we did normal summon Mabuku, so how are you going to be able to normal summon the new magician right there, performed by Empyrean Magician? We're going to fast forward the rest of the way, but we're going to take it a little slower. Okay, they're right there. As you notice, Electrum's going to pop the Servant, getting another plus one by putting it back to the Skeel. I understand you don't draw here, but that draw could be something useless you don't want, like another Dragon Shrine or something like that, and you don't really don't need it. When you have the situation where you could just pop the Servant and put in the Skeel, it's equally as good as popping the card, the draw card, especially when you know what's in your hand and they're all monsters, if that makes sense for you guys. And here we're going to put the Mighty Master, and I always try and put the Mighty Master in the Skeel as opposed to pen summoning it, because you're going to search Ravine in this combo at the very end for free, literally completely for free, if you want to, or if you have a Soyuzha, you're going to get a spell from Soyuzha, especially since you didn't Allure Upstart Mastery. You have so many live spells right now in your deck. So if you notice here, we have 3 counters on Jackal, 2 on Servant. Mighty Master is going to resolve by the end of this turn, so you get a free monster on field by that. It's like a free special summon, so why clog your field by pen summoning it when you get summoning out for free anyways? A little tidbit of knowledge for you guys. Now, how are we going to go? Harmon is going to summon a Dragon Pit. Look, we have 3 cards in hand. All right, LP, go bring out Triple Burst. It's too easy here. It's too easy. Now, here, you're left with a few options. You could do a Romulus. You could do a few cool stuff. But I'm like, you know what? Who needs a Dragon Ravine? I'm just going to go into Soyuzha here. You play a bunch of spells to draw into. So you're going to draw into Mastery there. Mastery's not going to get you anything good, but it's just a random spell card. Doesn't matter. Now, you're going to have 6 counters on the Jackal. You're going to summon this with the Soyuzha. Here's the cool part here. Now, this at the end phase is going to trigger out a card. We summon the pseudo from the graveyard targeting this, or the Jackal, doesn't matter, and you're gonna go with the Pisty. So it's a 6 interruption combo here, where Pisty summon on Triple Burst, Pisty and Soyuzha go into Seal, and now with the extra card, we're gonna go Triple Burst and Empyrean Magician into Appaloosa. And then we're going to, since we had all the free spells, gonna use the Mighty Master to summon itself. As I said, don't clog your board with the Mighty Master. End phase comes, and Empyrean Magician gets Harmonizing Magician to your hand. And just like that, we have Jackal, we have Mighty Master, we have Vortex, we have Seal, we have Aether coming out from Seal, so that's 5 interruptions. Appaloosa for 2 will always resolve because Seal's gonna bounce the card they attack with, so that's 7 interruptions. And then to make matters even worse for your opponent, when you negate a card, you bounce back Jackal with Mighty Master, right? So, and then when they destroy one of your cards, let's say when they attack the Seal or the Mighty Master, whatever it might be, sorry, the Seal, the Appaloosa, Then you special the chronograph to special the Mighty Master again, or the Jack, whatever you bounce back. So that's 8 interruptions with 4 cards in hand, and you're drawing for turn. So that's absolutely ridiculous, boys. Like, that is absolutely ridiculous. Like, your opponent's not doing anything here. And as you notice as well, Sayusha put back the gate 0. So you're getting a free gate 0 from Darkroom as well. So that's like 6 cards in your hand and 8 interruptions. That's ridiculous. And that's without Needle Fiber. Pendulums are broken. And the prowess of Magician's going second is what makes it even better. Because the cards like Dragon Pit, they're everything searchable, right? You discard a random dead side card with Pen Call. So it's like you can discard the extra cards. It's actually super nice. Now you should get the deck profile. So as you see here, it's a big Magician lineup. Because you do want to make sure you utilize Harmonizing once on your turn, once on the next turn of yours, with the Emperor Magician being allowed to add it back easily. So, 2 Harmo, usually I only play 1, but because the Emperor Magician, you get to add it back anyways. 1 Oath, like I said, is now a plus deck. The board, not like, you're going to have a broken board regardless. That board I had was 8 interruptions with 6 cards in hand by the end of it. When you drop return, you have 6 cards in hand. That's ridiculous. That's not even fair. And what are you going to do with the Jackal? It's not your hand trap, stop it. And that's why going second, you do want to play Pearl Poison. It's not the best card. Honestly, I would love to take it out. I played 40 in that version. This is my 41st card. Pearl Poison is very overrated. This format, as a card, Pearl Poison is broken. But in this format, it does nothing against Orcus. It does nothing against Salamangre. So I think you're going to have to wait and see in the balance when Orcus and Salamangre get absolutely destroyed to see if Purple Poison is suitable for the meta. But at the moment, it's not suitable for the meta. But I do put it in just in case. For its prowess going second. The 1 Dragon Caller, it still comes up. When you play a Guard Dragon deck, you need to play Dragon Caller. This is not debatable. And testing has come up way too much for me. And the fact that it's another level 7 that's not Dragon Pit comes up as well. Which in a future video, I'll show you guys how to play around awkwarder hands. Where you draw the Dragon Pit and the Harmonizing, you have no other level 7. That's why I put in the Dragon Caller. Because now you just lose a free card for nothing. And Dragon Caller saves you from, if Electrum gets impermanenced, you now have a Guard Dragon combo. And as you see, all you got to do is just go into LP and you have yourself a good enough board. And with the 4 cards in hand, because of the way the deck is built, you're going to win. So you don't need the biggest board. As long as you have Guard Dragon combo, you're good. That's why Caller is necessary. Dragon Pit is the best card going second for Magicians. Way better than Pearl Poison in this format. It's just absolutely mandatory. Some people play a very small Magician count and play Black Fang. Black Fang sucks, guys. As of right now, it sucks. When Celine comes out, Black Fang's going to be busted. And I can't wait to do cool plays that just really loop Black Fang once or twice in the turn easily. Unfortunately, you can't play Pen Call, but Pen Call's too good with it. But Selena Black Fang is a broken combo. I'll show you guys how to do some cool stuff with that as well when it comes out. 1 Time Gazer, Triple Chrono, Double Razor. I would like to play 3 Razor, but I'd like to try and cut my deck to 40. At the moment, I really can't cut it. If anything, I would cut Purple Poison. So to be honest, I would cut Purple Poison to 40. Just leave it like this. But I know a lot of you love Purple Poison. I don't want you guys crying while I'm not playing Purple Poison. Honestly, don't play it. Not right now. Wait until the balance. To be honest, what you should do is side 1 Purple Poison. Take out the Lekkery. This is a lot better. Put in the Pearl Poison for the side deck just in case you face a back row deck. And you win against back row decks anyway, so it doesn't matter. And Lekkery is slash too hard to go into anyways. 2 Razor, like I said, I like to play 3. The fact that it's a spell card, it's a turbo card, it's a high skill, there's so much use for it. You just want to play it. It ensures that no matter what, like Razor and Bumbuku equals full combo. Triple Servant, 1 Mighty Master, 1 Jaku, just 1 of each is all you need. You don't want to clog on them. I only play 2 Bumbuku versus 3 or versus 0. I think 2 is the correct number because the second you don't want to open 2 Bumbuku. All you want to do is just get 1 to search itself for a free plus 1 to discard off the Pen Call or a Ravine or whatever it might be. It's just a free plus 1. Plus 1s are huge in this deck, especially because of the Link shenanigans with Guard Dragons. Having a random monster is huge. As you see, you need a random monster to go into the Triple Burst. And you need a random monster when Pisty brings on Triple Burst to go into Appaloosa. So having random monsters is very good. That Bumbuku is huge for that. You just get a free card and free scale, whether low or high, whatever you want, because 5 is, it could be anything in this deck, to be honest. Triple Worm, 1 gate 0. Worm, just because you do play lots of discard outlets, so having triple is good. Distrudo, and going 8th is really just for going second, but it's still fine because of Seal. So it's like, because of Seal and 8th, your Appaloosa 2 negates always stands, and your opponent doesn't see it coming. And it's good first and second, so I do keep it in for that reason, to protect the Appaloosa. 1 Upstart, Triple Allure. We don't play Into the Void because you have like 5 cards in hand at the end phase. Triple Mastery, 2 Pen Call, 2 Duelist Alliance. I would like to play 3 Duelist Alliance, I really do. I'm trying to find space, but there's just no space, to be honest. And I don't want to make it a big deck. An option is to put in a third. Oh, I'm blind. I am playing 3 Alliance. I'm actually so blind. good. Good thing I found a way to play three. It's just really good, man. I understand drawing two dual signs seem dead, but it's really not. Because pen call, dual signs get pen call, just discard pen call. Like, you just pen call, discard, you're playing five pen calls, and the card's broken. Pen call's busted, man. I would want to play six. Like, you're not going to draw three, and you'll start usual always for your turn anyways. And if they negate it with Solemn Judgment, you guys use it again. Pen call's broken, man. This card's busted. And after siding against Orcus, like, look, you're siding these five cards against Orcus, right? Now, like, depending on what you want to take out. So what I would take out after siding would be maybe two Bumbuku, two Razor, one Magician. And now you're left with five cards where what if you draw two of them? Now the pen call could discard the extra one. Like, it is broken. You always want to see pen call in your hand. When I don't see pen call in my hand, I get a little scared. But I just realize I played the best deck anyways. So who really gives a shit? Why be scared when you're going to win regardless of pen call or not? But it is great to see it kind of ensures victory, just as every hand does. Now, look at the three Foolish cards. I opted for Foolish, Shrine, and Ravine. And there's a big reason for this, as opposed to one Foolish and double Shrine. Now, you do play Romulus. The card literally says, add a free Ravine to your hand. It's a free plus one, guys. Like, and a lot of the times, you're going to use Romulus to go into Ravine, and with, like I said, a lot of dead-ass monsters that you don't need, you link four of them into Sayusha, and you just get a free card to put back with Sayusha just for free. You get a free plus one. Like, it says this deck's a plus one deck. Now, you're going to end up with five cards in hand all the time. Like, you have, you're going to get this card all the time. You're going to get Dark Room all the time. That's three plus ones. Servant, you're going to get all the time, plus one. Pen Call, plus one. Oath, plus one. Bumbuku, plus one. Like, Foolish and Shrine, plus one. Extra deck, plus one. Like, plus ones are everywhere in this deck. That's why you end with four or five cards in hand, as opposed to garbage-ass doo-doo decks that end with, like, plus two. And, like, oh my god, look at my deck. Yeah, you suck. Now, you look at the side deck here. As I said, against Orcus, you put in these five. And the cards you take out, every deck is different in terms of what you side out. What I side out for the way this deck is built is if I'm going first. I'll talk about going first later. But going second, I would take out one Magician of my choice, two Razor, and two Bumbuku for these five. If I'm facing against back row decks, I put in two Evenly and triple Reboot, and I'll put in the Purple Poison. Purple Poison is good against a lot of decks going second, but against Orcus and Solid, it is not. So I could sometimes take out another Duelist Alliance, maybe a Ravine, if I want to for the sixth card for the back row decks or cards that Poison are good against, decks that are good against. Now against combo decks, you don't want to put in like Ash Blossom and the Hand Traps that do basically nothing. You put in two Evenly and three Dark Ruler, and they literally shit on everything. Evenly is the most underrated card in the meta right now, but obviously it's going to change when everything in this meta gets absolutely cucked on the ban list. Going first now, I do play one Sloth, double Secret Village, and I opt to take out my choice of whether it be a fifth Duelist Alliance, a Dragon Ravine, or an Aether. Well, Aether, I always take out because of the Sloth. And then, like, maybe one Razor or something, or two Razor, depending on what I feel like. Whatever you want between two, like, I'll show you the five. So, whatever you want between these five. So, Ravine, Duelist Alliance, two Razor. Take out two of these four for two villages. And substitute Aether for the Sloth. So, going first, you substitute Aether for Sloth. Unless Sloth doesn't hurt the deck, then you just put Aether back in. And then you take out whatever you want, two Secret Village for either Ravine, Duelist Alliance, the fifth pen call, or two Razor, whatever you want between these four, take out two of them. So let's say, for example, I take out this, for example. Whatever you personally want, it doesn't matter. One Razor or two Razor is fine. One Razor is fine. You can only use its effect once anyways. So playing once, it's great to see it, to be honest. And if you don't see it, who gives a shit? It doesn't really matter. So that's some side deck theory for you guys. All right, let's go back to how it should be here. We're going to put this back into the deck. Put this back into the deck. Put this back into the deck. And take out the Secret Villagers. Secret Villagers are only there for Dark Ruler, just so you guys know. And you Sayusha draw into it always anyways. Extra deck now. Electrum, LP, Triple Burst, Sayusha. Sayusha is important for the combo. Pisty, important for the combo. As you saw, Seal, Appaloosa, Nightmare Phoenix, Romulus, Boral Sword. Don't need to explain much of these, just play them because I said so. After Master Roll 5, you could literally take out all Guard Dragons and half these links. You just don't need them. Guard Dragons are fine post Master Roll 5 as well, but no need. Vortex, Absolute, Dweller, only rank 4, you'll ever need. Dragster, Savage Dragon, they all come up. That's the deck, guys. To be honest, the deck is just busted. I love this deck, first and second, with the new Magician. I really enjoy it. I wasn't a fan of the Magicians before, but the new Magician makes Pen Call so damn good not to play. Because now you have the choice of whatever you want here. They're all plus ones going first. Going second, they're all amazing. And Dragon Caller going is great going first. And typically going second, I substitute the Caller for the Poison. That's the deck, guys. Hope you like it. Hit the subscribe button. Check out your beautiful I'm a Demon Math mats in the description below, because you know what, they're beautiful and they're gonna run out soon. Check them out. Hit the subscribe button, hit the like button. We'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.